Yesterday, Donald Trump sent a letter to the SAG-AFTRA Actors Union announcing he was effectively resigning his membership from SAG. But that's only because they were actually about to kick him out. So it was your classic, you can't break up with me because I'm breaking up with you scenario. But here's the fun part of this story. Donald Trump sends this letter and it immediately goes around social media. First time I read it, I thought, ha, that's hilarious. You know, that sounds exactly like something he would write. Because I didn't think for a second that this was actually real. I was wrong. This is real. This letter that sounds like it was written by somebody pretending to be an exaggerated version of Donald Trump was actually written by Donald Trump himself. And of course, as usual, signed in his big ass Sharpie lettering there. I'm going to read this. I'm going to read the whole thing because this letter is just too insane to leave any part of it out. So here we go. Miss Carteris, I write to you today regarding the so-called disciplinary committee hearing aimed at revoking my union membership. Who cares? While I'm not familiar with your work, I'm very proud of my work on movies such as Home Alone 2, Zoolander, and Wall Street Money Never Sleeps, and television shows including The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Saturday Night Live, and of course, one of the most successful shows in television history, The Apprentice, to name just a few. I've also greatly helped the cable news television business, said to be a dying platform with not much time left until I got involved in politics, and created thousands of jobs at networks such as MSDNC and fake news CNN, among many others. Which brings me to your blatant attempt at free media attention to distract from your dismal record as a union. Your organization has done little for its members and nothing for me. Because that's always what it's about. Besides collecting dues and promoting dangerous un-American policies and ideas, as evident by your massive unemployment rates and lawsuits from celebrated actors who even recorded a video asking, "Why isn't the union fighting for me?" These, however, are policy failures. Your disciplinary failures are even more egregious. I no longer wish to be associated with your union. As such, this letter is to inform you of my immediate resignation from SAG-AFTRA. You have done nothing for me. You've done nothing for me. Isn't that kind of the mantra of Donald Trump's life? Isn't that how he is with every human being that he comes in contact with? Have you done something for me or have you not done something for me? Have you done anything for me lately? Have you done anything for me today? Was the thing you tried to do for me successful? Because if not, then that also doesn't even count. Just ask Rudy Giuliani. Still didn't get a pardon after everything he did for Trump. It's all about what can you do for me? It's all about trying to save his ego as well. That's the other part of this. Trying to make it seem like, oh, silly fools at the union. I decided to leave you. Ha, I win, as I always do. No, you look like a big friggin' baby. That's what you look like. Again, I legitimately thought that was a parody letter. I did not think it was real. While it does, of course, read like something Trump would say, it also reads like somebody pretending to be Trump. That's what they would say. But nope. That's the former president of the United States, ladies and gentlemen. Donald J. Trump, no longer a member of the Actors Union. Such a sad day for Hollywood. One of today's video sponsors is Privacy, and right now, they have a wonderful offer for all of our Ring of Fire viewers. Go to privacy.com/ROF, sign up for your Privacy account, and you will receive $5. Privacy.com, their service is absolutely one of the most vital in an online world today, especially during the pandemic. Everyone is encouraged to stay home, so we're ordering more things online. And so your bank account information is more vulnerable than ever. Privacy gives you security. This is a product that I use all of the time. And here's why. If you have ever had your bank account information stolen, if it's been part of a data leak, that is a massive headache trying to get your money back, trying to repair your credit. Privacy helps take away some of that concern. What privacy does is it provides a browser extension, or you can go right into the website or into the app, and it can create a virtual bank account or credit card number. It could be a temporary number that only is used one time, or it can be merchant specific, meaning you can create a bank account card that only works for one particular website. So if that account happens to get hacked or has a massive data breach, that card number no longer works with any other website. That is how privacy helps protect your bank account information in an increasingly insecure online world. So again, go to privacy.com/ROF. You get $5 free just for signing up. Or if you don't want to type it in, just click the link at the top of the video description below.